Well, Article 23, as you know, it's a very old story. I understand that the projects were abandoned in 2003 under strong popular pressure. People didn't want this amendment, but CCP is probably never abandoned the idea. They got it in Macau, so they never abandoned this idea. Well, I believe it's important for the population and the intellectuals and the academics and the churches in Hong Kong to protect their freedom of keeping within one state really a different system. And the different system is a system which includes religious liberty. And in UK, which was always the model for Hong Kong, religious groups are not discriminated for their ideas or for their criticism of any political party. Of course, if religious groups are guilty of common crimes, the persons responsible of the common crimes go to jail. And it's true that even in UK, groups which are recognized as responsible of a pattern of crimes may lose their charity status. However, this crime should be proved. It's not enough to say that a group commits crimes. These crimes should be proved. So I believe what the article, which seems to me at times to have been written by intelligence agents rather than by journalists. What the article really says is that in Hong Kong we should devise a system why organizations, and today it's a religion, tomorrow may be a political group or a dissident group, organizations not approved by CCP in mainland China should not be registered in Hong Kong. And that is tantamount to say that Hong Kong should become the same as mainland China, which was probably not the original intention of one state, two systems. It looks more like one state, one system, which is something different.